Ragnarok is coming. You're gonna need to stock up. Luckily, I'm offering new items. If I don't have it, you don't need it. Well, if you change your mind...
Freya, I've always wondered, why was Freya so revered here so quickly upon his first arrival?
Well, to begin with, it wasn't his first arrival. Very few know this, but Freya was one of the earliest visitors to Alfheim, back in the dawn of realm travel.
Oh? But before my time. You tell.
We believed for a long time that all the giants had died in the Flood, until one of them appeared in Vanaheim.
Enough talk for now. Be ready.
Much of the sand has been cleared away, but another storm rages beyond that pass, which must mean...
Another Hafgufar!
It looks as though the Light Elves sealed off this section of the Barrens. Why?
Luckily for us, a very considerate goddess has enhanced our magic chisel, and we can unseal it.
My, that is lucky.
The Forbidden Sands lay beyond.
Contested territory, according to Bela. And another storm to endure.
I remember when Freya and I traveled to this realm as children. The desert was healthy and full of life back then. I can't help but fear that era has ended for good and our efforts here are futile.
It's a fair concern. Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing Hafgufar. But I have to believe, in the long run, we're doing right by Alfheim. Best we start looking for a way underground.
Keep a lookout for a cave. The other Hafgufar must be under there.
Entrance. I hope Freyr will appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet, once this Hofgufa is free. This architecture... it is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
Or Hearthnetter as well.
I'd say we're on the right track, then.
Could I reach it from down here? No effect. Perhaps a different arrow.
This kind of hive material is sensitive to sound. Came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration. I didn't realize it was covered by hive matter.
Aye. And as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even our trapped Hafgifa for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
Thank you.
More hive, but denser. Well, there you go.
Another wretch to the left!
Underneath the Barrens, do they?
Territory changes hands often in Nelfheim.
Bigvir did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
I suspect the corpse below would disagree.
Doesn't like sound, remember?
Good eye. Let's continue, shall we?
Half goofers will allow them to breed again. It was a dazzling display once. The skies of Alfheim filled with their songs.
I imagine it's the lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate.
Huh?
I wonder if these two comprehend the choice they face once free.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hafgufa. In order to breed, they must pass on their light to their children.
And without light, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for in the end. That our death has purpose. That we can live on through our children. Well, given another chance, I know what choice I have. There's some Twilight Stone.
Aye. Back to the surface, then. Right side!
Thank you.
the pipe?
Used in many of Freyr's blessings, I imagine.
Fate of these creatures reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such power. So the blacksmith used the flame
of... Is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but... Well, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is the better storyteller.
Now don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story, Kratos.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died trying to protect her from those who would open it.
Well, at least it's a relatable story.
Solace in knowing you did what you thought was best for your son's safety. creatures know, there is little choice for a parent. You are not alone.
I'm not, am I? And now neither are they. Thank you, Kratos. This land sings once more. We've done good here.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens?
Light elf statue in the desert. Odd.
Aye. Fair bet this is the sanctum Bigvir spoke of.
What is that?
A phantom! Rogue magic! Aim for the runic core!
Bloody hell! Look at that thing!
That's
Fimblewinter, I suppose.
The magic draining out of all of us has to end up somewhere.
Lads, I thought death had cured me of my appetite, but damn if I can't stop thinking about the smell of tear stew. Awakened a fair few culinary cravings, did. Black pudding, haggis and neeps, oh!
Porridge and honey.
What about you, brother? Any pre-thimble winter foods you're aching for?
Olives.
The hell's an olive?
Go!
fair few birds you've hunted. I wonder if it might be worth visiting the Raven Tree.
Freya, do you mind picking up that story about your brother? I think you said a giant had appeared in Vanaheim.
That's right. Her name was Gerd, and she came offering to teach us the secrets of traveling between realms using Bifrost Light.
Another time. We must focus.
Hold that thought. I think it's about to get violent.
Face flank!
Freya, do you mind picking up that story about your brother? You mentioned a giant had come to Vanaheim to teach you of the Bifrost.
Yes, Gerd. Freya became immediately infatuated with her. He always yearned to wander, and along came someone who could truly show him how.